In 1967, every major car company in the world was struggling to invent the intermittent windshield wiper. The solution...
Hey, Dad! Mom wants to know where the blender is!
It's down here! He's taking it apart!
...came from a college professor in Detroit.
How are you, Mr. Mark?
I'm good. How are you?
Wonderfully blessed as always, and so are you.
Thank you.
Why would an accomplished producer like you want to direct?
It's just a different challenge. As a producer, sometimes if you're really a hands-on producer and you're sitting there making a movie, despite what the director's doing, you have your own opinions. You can look at someone and you say, wow, I'd put them in different jeans. I'd say they had a belt buckle. I don't like their hairstyle. If I was doing that, I would have that camera be over here, not there. Now, it doesn't mean you're right. It just means you normally have opinions.
A vision.
Mm-hmm. And what happens to me is after making all these movies, I've had a lot of visions.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Good job.
That was awesome.
Hey. Well, you see that car across the street?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Look at the driver staring at me. He thinks I'm turning the wiper on and off here. Look at this. No. Look here. Look at that, mister. No hands. He's wondering what the heck's going on. How's he doing that?
No hands.
Hi.
You have to have the passion about the story. You're gonna breathe it for, you know, in my case, 9 years. It better be something you really, really care about. And in this case, I was just passionate about this story.
Your attachment with the project Flash of Genius, did it start with the article?
Yeah, there was an article in the New Yorker, and one of the producers, Mike Lieber, brought me the article. I read the article, and I just, you know, I was in the movie business. I loved it. They wanted me to option it, to produce it. I said, the good news for you is I'm going to option it. And they were all, yay! And I said, the bad news for you is I think I'm going to direct it one day. And they were like, oh, okay, sure, because, of course, they wanted to sell the property. And it turned out to be true. I just had a feeling about it, Manny. I don't know what it was. I just loved this tale of a guy, little guy, who's not going to take it.
Right.
He's just not going to take it. You know what? I'm going to fight.
It's the classic David trying to bring Goliath to his knees.
Yeah, and about how emotional that kind of a story is, and about that it doesn't come easy. That's not going to be so easy. You're not going to just pull the slingshot, hit him in the eyes, he's going to drop.
That's it right now.
It's not that story.
This is about more than money. I always thought I was put here on this earth for a purpose. I thought it was to be an engineer. Or maybe an inventor, but that's not it, and now I know what it is.
God put you here to sue the Ford Motor Company.
Look, I brought these here thinking that you had different ideas. Edwin Armstrong invented the FM radio. Somehow RCA ended up with a patent. He jumped out a 13-story window. This was a good man.
It was great. I mean, he's a dedicated, really serious actor who really cares about, I mean, he's funny and he can do all the comedy. It was exciting for him because this was probably one of the biggest challenges he's had, and it was a big challenge for me as a producer, as a director. So he had my challenge that way, him taking on a role that was one of his most demanding. And then we got, you know, someone like Lauren, who is just so talented, and then Alan Alda came aboard, and Dermot. So I had this group of really, you know, all of them were, as I said the very first day, including the crew, I said, I've made a lot of movies, but every single person on here has done their job longer than I have.
Yeah. We're going to have to go it alone.
Going to the law library is not going to make you a lawyer, Bob.
Kearns versus Ford.
I'm not sure why, but I understand you'll be representing yourself.
My son Dennis will be helping me out.
It's great. He's nothing short of genius, and I enjoy the movie.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Nice to meet you.
I do know where you go is where I want to be.
Makes you wonder what makes a man successful. Brains? Talent? Maybe it's some other thing.